Hey, how you doing? This is Jim. I was going to do a rant about CNBC, that TV station that allegedly discusses financial situations and whatever. I don't know what the hell they are. And a lot of people complain about Fox being the propaganda arm of the Republican Party, I guess. But CNBC, people give that a free pass, man. They're very, very bad. Now, Jim Cramer's a very funny guy. He's very witty. He's well-informed, apparently. And he has connections with Wall Street. And you'd think it'd be of some value just to watch him. And I don't know, it's his stock picks. If you look on the internet, he's about 50-50. Although when he says a specific stock will get to a specific price, sometimes you got to keep an eye on that because he does have his Wall Street connections and they manipulate prices. And, you know, sometimes he gets those right. Back when I was an accountant with a Fortune 500 company, at lunch hour one time, believe it or not, I went and picked up my 357 Magnum at the local gun store. And I brought it into work. You know, I'm not going to leave it in the car. The CFO and a couple other executives seemed to be intrigued by it. It was a company that was owned like 51% by a family that enjoyed hunting and they were familiar with firearms, so it was like no big deal anyway. But in the stock market, you have bulls and bears. In the Catskill Mountains, you have chipmunks, porcupine, and bears. Now, when I have an old hiking video on YouTube, but I just did one the other day. But about a week before that, I went up there to Hunter Mountain in the Catskills of New York State with only this little knife here. No firearm, just this little knife that could barely even skin a squirrel. And about a mile, excuse me. About a mile in, I think I heard a bear. It was some creature that lowered itself down from a tree, landed in the leaves, and then it was silent. I mean, unless it was a huge chipmunk. A chipmunk couldn't make that. Chipmunks like scamper along the leaf surface. This thing went plop, and there was nobody there. So, you know, I assumed it was a bear, so I did as the notice says you should do at the trailhead, which is to back up slowly and walk away. I backed up slowly, and then I ran like hell down this damn trail. I had a tendency to look at the trail, thinking the thing was following me, but I assume that the bears don't really follow the trail markers and they just run straight for you. I don't know. Anyway, the next time I went, which was a few days ago, I brought this knife, which is a little bit more security, I guess. Still, you know, you have to keep your eye. I don't want to surprise a bear if you're sitting there eating something. I don't want to shock it and get it upset. Anyway, I was very disappointed in myself in terms of climbing up that fire tower, as you'll see in the video. I only went up 3 flights once again, man. I guess when I get to the top of this mountain, although it's only 4,040 feet in altitude there, I'm just so tired and everything, my body's shaking. The fire tower is shaking from the wind. The fire tower is shaking from the weight of my body as I'm going up, and so. But next time, I guarantee I'm going up 2 more flights at least. You know, I was just afraid something might happen and I'd be there for like a day or two until the next hikers come up there, and then I'd have to hang out with the bears. You know, become one with the bears. So that's about it. Hey, if anyone's from the old discussion groups that are viewing any of these things, feel free to make a comment, and I hope everything's okay with you all. Everybody